Why so messy?
Hey, what are you doing?
Oh, I just put everything in the specific folder so I can find easy for next time.
Nah, that's not the way you clean your desktop, man. Step out. Let me show you how. One click.
What up everyone, this is Tommy and welcome back to the channel. Today we're gonna take a look at 10 best Mac applications that will need to boost your productivity at work. They are all very light and super easy to set up, and of course I will leave all the link in the description below. Let's check it out together. So the first thing we will take a look is Better Snaptune. I think its name tells everything. Better Snaptune gives you the ability to manage window size and its location just by drag and drop. So as you see, I have a small windows on my desktop right now, and as I move it around my desktop, Better Snaptune will give me a preview of what size gonna be and where it's going to snap to. And also on its settings, you can do even more than just snap. You can customize its preview appearances, also the shortcut, until it matches the way you like it. This one is one of the best Windows 11 features, and now it is great to bring it to your Mac. Dropzones is the next app that we're going to talk about. If you need to deal with a bunch of files and applications every single day, this app would definitely be for you. So Dropzones provides a place where you can stash temporary files for later use. You can create the Dropzones by selecting any files with different type and drag it directly to the drop bar. And you can create as many drop bar as you want. So you can either email it or airdrop it or move it to the trash, or you can send it to the chat box. From here, I can drag directly to the chat box to send to my friend. Also, Dropbar gives you the ability to quick access to folders and apps. To add that, you can click to add to grid and select one of these functions or open applications to add any app for quick access. Let's say I want to add RGB media encoders. I click to this and click open. And now from here, I can have a quick access to RGB media encoders. The next one will be OneChat Pro. This one will be super helpful for anyone who works in e-commerce industries where customer service is extremely important. So OneChat Pro provides you with multiple message platform. As you can see, so over here we have messengers, Telegram, Skype, Twitter, even Tinder you can add over here by clicking to this, and then you will have the windows over here to log in. And the best thing is you can log in with multiple accounts within one application. Just click create and then log into your account. And Myna is the next application I want to introduce to you. It basically brings the Google Translator into your menu bar without accessing to any other browsers. So just click into this and you have your Google Translator over here. It is had over 100 languages and gorgeous dark theme appearances. You can even change the opacity of this window under its preferences over here. Also, the best thing is Myna only stick on the menu bar. It doesn't have any dock icons. So once you finish translated, just move your cursor outside the window and clicks, and it automatically disappear. Doesn't bother your screen. Now, if you are working in multinational company, Numi will be your best friend. If Myna give you a quick translator, then Numi will give you an instant answer for basic math, currently exchange, and even time zone. So we have Numi over here. We'll do some of the basic converts like time in specific locations, and also basic math Also, here you can see I do the currency exchange from USD to Vietnam dongs. After I have the results over here, I just click to this and it will instantly copy to my clipboard. CleanShot X will be the next productive applications. This app will change the way you usually take a screenshot and screen recording on your Mac. If you need to write product documents, product tutorials, this app will be a great saver. Because after you take a screenshot, you can start edit right away with a lot of effects. So over here we have an icon of CleanShot X, and you can see we have a lot of options. Capture areas, capture full screen, and capture windows. And now I will select to capture area just to show you that CleanShot X has a lot of effects. And once we got a screenshot over here, we have multiple options. You can either pin it over here for, let's say you take a screenshot of a quick note and you can pin it to your screen. You don't have to save it on your desktop. Or you can edit it with these icons, or you can upload it to the cloud and send the link to your friend, or you can delete it right away with this X. So let's say I want to edit it, I click to this. So you see we have a lot of options over here. You can crop it, you can make a shape, you can draw a clip here, and adding a text. Even the text has its own effects. And one of the best features, you can draw a blur area. So this one is super helpful for anyone like me. Sometimes I do tutorial videos, but I want to hide my personal information. So this one is the best. And talking about the best feature, we have a numbers. If you do product tutorial, this one is great. And when you finish, you can either to airdrop it, send it to the cloud, or you can save it to the desktop, or just copy it to the clipboard. But what makes this app unique is, I think, its ability to capture a really clean windows with a transparent background. Let's say I have a small windows over here, and let's click to the dropdown again and select to capture windows. And immediately we have an overlay colors. So that's just for us to easier indicate what window we want to capture in case we have multiple windows, right? So I just selected this, and right away you can see over here I have a very clean shot of this window specifically and with the transparent background. And of course I can add a lot of effects. And after I finish, I click done. Now we're gonna talk about screen recording. It also has multiple options from screen capture to even making a GIF. And you just select over here to click to record screen to do the screen recording. So you see we have two options over here that I mentioned. And in here you can choose either to do not record the audios or select the microphone input. And we have small settings over here. And of course, if you want to do more settings, you can go to this icon again on the menu bar and click to preferences. And in here, you can adjust the setting for specific area like recordings or even making a shortcut to get better with the software. Lunar gonna be the next applications that I want to talk about. If you have an external monitor, this app will save you a lot of time whenever you want to change the screen brightness for each monitor. So if you click to the Lunar icons on the menu bar, you can either manually decrease or increase each monitor brightness, or you can select the standard preset over here for both monitors. Because in this case, I have two monitors. But if you have three, you can also select the standard preset for all three monitor. Let's say I just want 50% of brightness on all of my screen. I can click to this. And also on its preferences, you can do even more with its settings. You can do configurations. Also, you can do shortcut. There's a lot of complex shortcut over here. You can alter in the way you like it. The next app will be a better file rename. So you're gonna think why I need a tool to rename my file when I just need to right click to it and rename it instantly. Yes, it might be effective with one file, but now we're talking about 1000 to 2000 files. This app will rename all of the files under 5 seconds. So I just opened the app right in front of you, and we have very basic appearance over here. Let's say I have multiple files and I want to add custom text to the beginning of each files, and I would select text in the categories. And you see, you can select all the things like date, time, sequence numbers, and character positions. And but you have very flexible choice over here. And on the actions, I will select add text to the beginnings. I can add text to the end or insert text in front of existing text. Yes, you have a lot of options over here, but I will select to add text to the beginnings. And now it will ask what text you want to add to this file. I will type Tommy over here, and now it still asks you the options. You want to change the entire file name and extensions, or you just need to change the file name without the extensions. Or I just stick with the first option, change the entire file name extensions. Now you just need to drop the file that you want to change the names. Let's say I want to change the 6 file. I'm gonna drop here. So now you can see we have a preview on our right hand side of what the text gonna look like in final. After you check and everything is correct, you just need to select to perform rename and rename all. And it says 6 file name will change. Click OK and that's it. And now all of the file will change to the correct format that you've chosen earlier. That's easy. You don't have to resave it to the folders and download it. That's just too much work for rename. Best Mac app productivity number 9 is Cleaner Uninstaller Pro. Most of the app will be deleted easily by just dragging to the trash. It might be delete the app itself, but the app related files will still on your Mac, and by the time goes by will buy up your storage with the other sections. And if your other section is full right now, you can check this video right here to how to completely clean it but not touch you to any system files. That's super dangerous. Okay, so we come back with this app over here. We have app cleaner and uninstaller, very good appearances. And what this app can do is make you even more surprised. So we have a lot of sections over here. We have applications, startup programs, extensions, remain files, and open with. We have a lot of things here. And the first sections, applications. Let's say I want to uninstall CleanShot X. I will select this one and drag to the uninstall application panel. And right away, it has the window to show me how big this file is. It say 3.46 gig selected and contains 64 items. And let's say if you just delete the CleanShot X applications and you still have 63 more files under this application that you cannot find it, you can click remove to run the uninstall programs, or in this case I just click cancel because I still need to use this app, right? Alright, so you can do the same with all the applications that you don't want anymore. And now we come with startup program. This is super interesting for anyone who usually turn on and off your Mac. You can review what application you want to open whenever you just randomly restart your Mac. You can check or uncheck over here, and also you can review what extensions on your browser right now. Remaining files is a section for files without destinations. It doesn't contain in specific applications or files, so it's just here. But sometimes it might be a system file, so just leave it, don't touch it. And on the preferences, make sure you grant access for this app so it can have better look at your Mac and also make your Mac cleaner. The last applications will be Noizio. This app has many different ambient sounds which will help you focus, relax, and increase your productivity. Of course, we work and now we need to relax by music, ambient music, the best thing for your productive. I save it for last because I think this one make you the most productive. Some tip, some application, maybe you don't like it, but who doesn't like music, right? You? Okay, so let's open this app, Noizio. Okay, so we have the app over here. You can access the app in the menu bar again, and you have a different style. We have bird in back, blue whale, brown noise, campfire. Yes, a lot of things, and you can even save it. Save the mixtures to collections. Let's say, take me to the beach. Collections. Some sort of that, and you know, you can set it to here. Yeah, just easy like that. Enjoy. All right, guys. Thank you for watching until this part of the video. Really appreciate that. This is definitely a long video, and you see I changed two shirts, which means I took many days to finish this video. Now it's 2 a.m. in the morning. Again, I'm gonna edit the videos and post it tomorrow. But thank you again for watching, and of course I will see you in the next video. Please give me a like and subscribe. Goodbye.